Hello, Gavin Hoey here with another Photoshop quick tip. Now, in my previous video, I showed you a nice walk down the high street at Taormina in Sicily where I was out and about taking photographs. Now, that was brilliant. I really enjoyed myself and it generated a lot of questions from you guys. What did I do to the pictures? What's my technique? And, you know, what's my secret? Well, there's not really any secrets. There's no magic going on here. So I thought I'd put a little tutorial together to show you one of the techniques I used, which is called colour popping, which is where you take a normal colour image, get rid of all the colour, and then selectively return the colour to certain parts of the picture. Okay, so here's one of the pictures I took down in Taormina. It's exactly as it came off the camera, nothing done to it at all. So I'm just going to apply a few different effects in the basic panel here. I like to increase the contrast on my pictures, so I'm going to get the clarity and push the clarity all the way to the right-hand side, plus 100. Now that bumps up the contrast on the mid-tones, but I'm also going to give it a general contrast enhance as well, and a touch on the blacks too, to really give this a bit of feeling, a little bit of texture, and it just kind of works for me. Another thing I'm going to do is just darken the corners, so I'm going to jump to the lens correction tab and get the lens vignetting and just slide that down just to put a little bit of darkness just in the corners. Okay, that's looking pretty good. We're going to change tools now to my favourite tool, but quick note here, this is only available in Photoshop CS4 or Lightroom 2 and 3. So if you're an Elements user or an older version of Photoshop, you haven't got this little brush here. This is the adjustment brush, and this is the tool I'm going to use to make that black and white stroke color effect. So with the adjustment brush selected, I'm going to come down to the saturation option and drag it all the way down to the left-hand side, minus 100, no saturation whatsoever. And I'm just going to paint minus 100 saturation all over my picture, which of course does exactly what you expect. It takes away all of the colour. So we're down to a nice kind of black and white image. Now, to selectively bring colour back, I'm going to change the settings of the adjustment brush. You can see here it says New, Add and Erase. Now I'm going to change it to erase. Now this will erase the effect of the adjustment brush. And the effect, of course, was to remove the colour. So if we erase it, we bring the colour back. So a few things you can change. You can change the size of your brush. You can change the feathering, so how hard your brush edge is. And you can change the flow, which is the one I actually like to change. You can change the flow. The flow is almost like the opacity. Let's try it on down to 1. If I put 1 on here, you see nothing happens whatsoever. But if I put my flow up to 100, then when I paint, the eraser tool works very quickly and rather too vibrantly. So I'm just going to undo that with Control and Z, and I'm going to put my flow down to where it was before, which is around about 30, where I like to keep it. And I'm just going to paint on with 30. Now this will bring the colour back, but with a much gentler edge. Now that still means you get colour coming through, but it's not quite as vivid and vibrant. And against that black and white background, sometimes a really vivid and vibrant colour isn't what you want at all. And if I do the same on this one. Now if you want a more vibrant colour, it's not a problem. You can just brush over a few times, and that'll just bump the colours up where you run the brush over multiple times. Like that. There's one down here as well, and I think we need that one in there. Like so. And we'll come up to this one here. And you can see it's really just a matter of just painting over areas where you want to bring the colour back through. Lovely. Marvellous. And finally, up there as well. So there you go. It's as simple and as quick as that. Okay, let's just come out of that brush and we'll just see the difference. We'll just go back to our original image exactly as it was shot. And then our adjusted image by using the adjustment brush.